Hi, it's Allison Pentland from offtheporch.ca and Fee541 Costumes. I operate a costume online service and costume concierge out of Mississauga, and I work with families throughout Canada. But today we're going to talk about the end of the school year. It's that time when parents are panicking, they're opening up their kids' backpacks, and they're finding notes from the teachers about end of school kind of accumulating events. So there's dance recitals, there's speeches, there's all kinds of projects and plays. In this case, I was contacted by a parent who was responsible for outfitting for Robin Hood. So to get any of that kind of knight costume or even like a noble lady costume seems to be pretty easy in the GTA. There are independent retailers like Amazing Party, myself, Kids Costumes, and we operate all year round. We carry those kinds of costumes and hats and props, swords and things like that. But in this case, one of the things that this theater director and the parents were looking for were tunics for the forest gang of Robin Hood. And so we decided to do a DIY, and I had a lot of fun doing it. What I did is I went to my local thrift store and I bought men's linen or cotton shirts in men's medium or large, that very generous size for that age group. Some of them were white, some of them were khaki, and some of them were green. So sticking with all the natural tones that would have been available in that time, including kind of a gray blue, which would have been made with woad plant dye. These are short sleeve shirts so that the child can wear a long sleeve shirt underneath. And what I did is I removed the pocket and I removed all the buttons. I stitched it together up to here. Very simple. I can't sew. I'm a terrible sewer, so that was pretty easy for me. Then what I did is I poked a hole and I put through, in this case it's kind of like leather laces, but you can use shoelaces, you can use yarn, you can use twine, and that you can pull shut if you want it tighter on the child, that leaves room for them to put over their head. I didn't do anything on the bottom, I just cut out all the labels. In the cases of the white ones and the khaki ones, I did actually use RIT dye to take them from a bright white. You can also do a tea stain dipping. But in this case, the school parents and the theater person, teacher wanted greens. So these are all different shades of greens. The difficult part was actually taking off the pocket. I used a stitch ripper, and this would be a great DIY for a child to do, really, like knitting or anything else. It teaches patience. Or you can sit in the TV, in front of the TV, watch the news and rip the stitches. But otherwise, the sewing was very easy. I just used a kind of natural color gray threads. And so the shirt was $9, and then the belt, which I'd also recommend, unless you have a belt at home, preferably brown, about 2 inches, and you want it to fit around their hips, and this is where somebody in that time period would have been able to have quick access to their sword or their dirk, which is their dagger, their knife. We carry our clothing items all year round. This was a special order for the family, and I also had the instructions available in case the parents wanted to do it themselves. I really like that idea of DIY for school plays. I think it's a great teaching tool for kids. So I hope you find that of interest and helpful. Maybe not this year, but maybe next year. And again, it's Allison Pentland Folk from offtheporch.ca and Fee501 Costumes, Mississauga, Ontario. Hope you enjoyed this ditty. Have a great day.